the waiting and anticipation. Probably killing all of us here because we are just over 24 hours away from Call of Duty Black Ops 4's global launch, but we got a lot of stuff to talk about, and one thing in particular that really just dropped a huge bombshell on us, that being an official surprise livestream from Treyarch. This might be what they were referencing back in their Reddit post the other day in which they said they were going to be talking about some changes that were going to be coming with a day one update, but regardless, this actually gave us a ton of stuff to look forward to, not only if you end up having an earlier copy and when servers eventually go online, but also for what we can end up seeing just when the game officially launches, because we had, again, a lot of this stuff locked behind that sort of initial wall, and while there were ways around it, we got some more information that was more so confirmed from stuff that was rooted in offline leaks, but also a little more deeper than that, because it's actually the full game with that patch showcased for the first time. So today we're gonna be breaking down everything you need to know here out of this, everything that Treyarch gave us officially, so that this is probably gonna be the last update video going into Black Ops 4, and then we're just gonna jump into everything with the actual launch of the game. But before we get into that, I want to let you guys know, stick it right here up on the channel, because I actually ended up getting access to the game from an event that we ended up having last week out in Los Angeles, hosted by Treyarch, and we got a lot of stuff to talk about, a lot of cool things up on deck. Not sure if we'll get it up in time, but the time I'm cleared to post is 12:01 a.m. Pacific Standard Time today, I guess, maybe while you're watching this, the 11th, so a day early, and we'll be posting all throughout the day, and of course doing some streams as well, both here and on Twitch, but keep it right here up on the channel. We got a ton of content coming, starting in just a few hours now even, so make sure you don't go anywhere with that. If you're new, hit the subscribe button so you don't miss a single thing. But that said, jumping into the content at hand. So the first thing we can detail here is we actually got a few new weapons detailed to us and officially revealed from what we ended up seeing in the full game. Now, we didn't have these in the beta, obviously, these are brand new. We have the Outlaw Sniper, the RK7 Garrison Burst Pistol, a new LMG, and apparently there's two new LMGs compared to the beta. They didn't really give as much information on that one, but we ended up seeing one that looks to be called the VKM. Now, the Outlaw, the Sniper, is what really catches my attention out of the three that was mentioned. We ended up seeing that it's sort of like a revolver sniper rifle. And they went into detail a little bit about the Operator mod here at this one. And if you guys aren't familiar with how Operator mods works, it's kind of like an extra bonus perk that makes it sort of much more powerful in a specific way, but it will cost you in total, I think, about 3 creative class slots is what it ended up taking out of your pick 10 in the beta, and probably will do so here now in the full launch of the game. So it adds a very awesome perk to your weapon and something that helps out greatly, but it definitely takes away and limits the rest of your class that you can use. So it kind of balances itself out there, but the Operator mod for the Outlaw Sniper is a burst on that sniper. So you're almost guaranteed a one-shot kill because you're shooting multiple shots with that one single shot, which is pretty cool, but we'll see if that gets tuned or not at all, because that sounds kind of crazy, but again, high risk, high reward type of deal. The RK7 Garrison is one that, honestly, very interested to see how that one turns out, being that it's a burst pistol, probably going to be the new meta pistol here for this, because we had the Strife before, and then the Mozu also was in the betas as well, and those are, of course, decent for semi-autos, but you can't get as many shots off as compared to a burst. Some other talking points about multiplayer is that Treyarch said they've made numerous balancing improvements to weapons in multiplayer, so if there was something that really seemed overpowered, it might not necessarily be exactly how you remember it from the beta. They also said they're very happy with the balance right now, but of course, as always, we'll continue to monitor everything because that's just how things go. We're going to have tunings and everything as the year goes on. That's inevitable. Treyarch also introduced us to the NVIR optic, an optic that was not in the beta for any weapons, but it's going to be available on some certain weapons within the full launch version of Black Ops 4. This is a combination of a thermal sight, but also a night vision sight. So while it might seem weird at first because there are no night maps, at least to our knowledge at the moment, Nuketown might have a darker aesthetic from the teasers that we've seen, but for everything else that is considered, the reasoning behind the night vision portion of this came down to people hiding in shadows, people going into more dimly lit areas and sitting in a corner with that, so this will hopefully be able to help counter. And that's going to be available again on a various number of weapons. What we ended up seeing was footage of the Auger DMR. We saw it also on the Swordfish, and so with those two being tactical rifles, it seems like we might get those optics on the tacticals, and then my guess, presumably also going to be on snipers as well, since we've normally seen thermals on snipers also. But for right now, we don't have any real confirmation of it, but that's gonna be coming. Additionally, 3 new score streaks were revealed. The Drone Squad, which is a squad of drones that do recon for the map. The Sniper's Nest, which is a helicopter that flies in featuring 2 professional snipers on each side of the helicopter and takes out enemies with a 50 cal weapon. It's one shot, one kill, so hopefully a nice reward for players that get to call this in. I'm assuming to kind of counter it, you just have to take out the snipers in the helicopter and they also confirmed the return of the dart. Now, as for other score streak improvements, the RCXD was something that got better vision and better handling and was able to navigate more effectively. So that's something that if you use that in the beta and weren't necessarily too pleased with it, hopefully this should then help you out a little bit. The attack chopper was also improved, to which the meme was made, some might actually say it's devastating. If you guys remember, that was the whole joke about the beta, the score streaks were going to be devastating, but they were rather underwhelming. So that apparently got a big buff to that as well. One other mechanic change, not necessarily score streak change, was that of the drop shot. It's a tactic as old as COD itself, and it's something that's been around for ages. Not a lot of people may be too keen about it, but it's something that in Black Ops 4, initially with what we saw in the beta, you couldn't actually drop shot. It became an RNG hip fire spread whenever you tried to drop, but now that's actually going to be kind of balanced out because you can still drop shot, but you also can't. How you do it though, you need to equip the stock 2 attachment on your weapon, which of course first requires stock 1 and then will cost you more in your create a class slots in terms of how many you use out of the pick 10. So that's gonna be something that kind of counters that, but also will be available there for players that truly feel like they need to drop shot. The tracker perk ends up having a huge change here for this one. There's now an eyeball on your map when you appear on anyone's mini map, which also includes the fog of war, not just somebody with a sweeping UAV. Talking about the fog of war, it's now a cone instead of a circle, which is a little change up again compared to what we saw in the beta and all gameplay earlier. There also is the perk Team Link, which will give you better situational awareness and give you more of that fog of war, which gives it a little bit more purpose here because in the beta it wasn't necessarily the most used perk, but you can end up getting a little bit more here out of it as a result. The spawn system was also drastically changed and fine-tuned from what Treyarch said, and they are very, very happy, which is a direct quote with it. So definitely nice to see that it's a little bit more confidence in that one now. Stim Shot was too crutch in the beta, it's been dialed back. We end up seeing a little bit out of this, maybe just in terms of the cooldown time, maybe the time that it actually takes because it's no longer instantaneous, which is something that we saw on the very tail end of the beta. And the final thing talking about multiplayer and just generalities was that LMGs might be a little bit of a problem because there's very little to almost no flinch, they said, while ADSing with an LMG. So hopefully we don't come into too many situations with that, but we'll see how it plays out. I'm assuming if it becomes a problem, it will be fixed and adjusted as time progresses. But as for Blackout stuff, I'm super stoked for this one. Hopefully you guys are as well. I love Blackout. I'm very excited to jump into it. Level 3 armor has been reduced in the spawn rates around the world. It will now less often spawn. Whether that actually means only in supply drops or like maybe one every couple quadrants that it spawns on the ground, who knows, but it's going to be more rare than what you normally see it, or at least at the very early beginning of the beta. Changes to muzzle flash are coming to release, and these are sort of just lighting in darker rooms. They don't want to mess with your field of view or anything like that that may impair your actual gun skill or your gunfighting abilities. When you're outside the zone, not as much red will be on your screen this time. That's something that they felt was a little too much whenever you were outside the zone in the beta. A huge, huge thing to me that is an absolute blessing from Treyarch are that we got a bunch of audio updates. The first one, if you guys remember in the beta, we talked about this, spatial audio was completely messed up. If you were, say, even just in the relative vicinity of somebody, but there were multiple stories to a building, you couldn't tell if they were right next to you, a floor below you, or a floor above you. It really didn't matter because it just sounded like they were right next to you the entire time. That's been fixed out now. Walls will now add sort of dampening to that, and so you'll either be able to tell how far away or how close somebody is from that. Teammates' footsteps are now quieter, and also, under the audio options and settings, there's now a ton of different mix settings to play around with, which I'm totally cool with. I absolutely love messing with those sound mixes, and they definitely can help out in a lot of different situations. Looting has been changed ever so slightly as well. It's a new option, the tap to pick up. There was a lot of talk about this within the beta. My personal thing was that I just didn't want to look down and pick up every item. Didn't really mind holding the button down. I just didn't want to look down for it. But that's actually been changed in both regards. You can now tap to pick up, and you also don't have to look down. It can be just in your vicinity, and it will end up coming up with that dialogue box that'll say tap or hold to actually pick up. As for the HUD, you'll end up seeing your teammates are now downed a lot easier. There's a new section called cleanup kills, in which I'm probably just gonna guess that that is whenever somebody's down, you finish them, that's where you get credited in the cleanup kills category. There's a lot more stats now in the after action reports and in the barracks, it seems like. Every 20 levels, you'll also apparently get a brand new Blackout character. For those of you guys that don't remember, there's also 80 levels in Blackout total. There's been changes to the merit system to better suit the mode based on feedback. From what they detailed, it's 10 merits or 10 points per kill, which of course will then maybe incentivize high kill games. From the image detailed, looks like you get 50 for top 5 and a win is 100, but you can also get both if you end up winning. And apparently hit markers are actually different now for what you're actually hitting, whether it be players, armor, or vehicles, which will be definitely nice to see that it adds a little bit more of clarity as to what you're actually hitting. And the final player count was actually finally detailed here for launch of what we can expect for Blackout, which isn't one solid number, which is kind of interesting to think about. But for solos and duos, a lobby's gonna start up with 88 players. But for quads, you're gonna have 100 player lobbies. So it adds for a little bit more action as more people come in and play. I think that honestly, that's not all that bad. It's only a 12 player difference. And for the types of play styles you'll encounter, that's definitely gonna be, I think, a nice fluid transition into the modes. So I'm totally cool with that, but that is what Treyarch detailed here for us out of the surprise live stream, literally out of nowhere. So hopefully you guys enjoyed, hopefully you found this insightful, but man, I'm excited. I cannot wait. So much information dropped and of course so much more coming. So that's what we're gonna wrap it up. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. What is your favorite part here detailed out of this? Are you guys a fan that drop shotting now takes an extra step to be done? Is it something that you hope negates that a little bit? Are you guys excited for the Blackout player counts? Whatever it is, let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. But of course, make sure you stick it right here up on the channel, because like I said, we got a ton of content starting in just a few hours for Black Ops 4. So stick it right here on the channel. We're gonna be continuing the coverage with the best possible content here that I can bring you. A ton of tips, guides, tutorials, all that good stuff. We got you covered here up on the channel. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you drop a like down below. Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new and want to stay up to date with all things Black Ops 4, Black Ops 4 multiplayer, Blackout, zombies, you name it, we got you covered. And if you guys also want to follow over on Twitter and Instagram, those links are down there in the description below if you guys want to check those out. Also, we want to follow over on Twitch. We've been doing some live streams over there as well. So that's where we're at, man. I'm excited. That is all we got here for today. And we are so, so close. Just about 24 hours away from the launch of Black Ops 4, or maybe even less, depending on where you're at in the world. But for now, we have a little bit to wait left. I'll see you guys later though. Thanks for watching. Take care and peace.